Blood has been a precious resource for doctors in saving lives. The easiest way to get the blood is voluntary blood donation. If you are in age group of 18 to 60 with normal blood pressure, then there is a high chance that you have donated the blood at least once. But have you ever wondered what happens to the blood that you had donated? The standard procedure for collection of blood is uniform throughout the world. If you are at least 45 kgs with hemoglobin level of 13.5 gram per deciliter, then you can donate 350 to 450 ml blood in every 6 months. The blood that you donate is collected in a blood bag. This bag has some compounds like citrate phosphate and dextrose adenine in it. These compounds work as anticoagulant and prevent blood from clotting. This blood is then stored at 2 to 6 degrees Celsius. This blood bag is transferred to laboratories where it is screened for some infectious disease which can spread through blood. Some of these diseases are HIV, malaria, syphilis, hepatitis B and C. After passing this examination, the blood is transferred to centrifuge. The centrifuge rotates at 1500 G for 5 to 7 minutes. This process creates 3 layers in the blood sample. The uppermost layer, which is about 55% of blood, is yellow plasma. This is kept at minus 18 degrees Celsius or lower temperature. It contains proteins like globulin, albumin, fibrinogen, etc. This component is used in treating severe bleeding disorders. The lower level, which is about 45% of blood, is RBC. It is used in treatment of anemia and kept at 4 degrees Celsius. Middle layer, which is less than 1% of blood, contains white blood cells, platelets, etc. It is used in thrombocytopenia and bleeding disorders. The platelets are kept at a device known as platelet agitator. With the advancement of technology, some additional factors like antihemophilic factor, factor 8, factor 9, and antibodies can also be separated. These may be used to treat blood clotting disorders and severe infections. That is how all the components of blood are separated and kept at different temperature and in different equipments in blood bank. And when there is need, the blood can be transferred to other person. With this blood, at least 4 lives can be saved. So just remember that you may not be Superman or Batman to save thousands of lives, but you still can save at least 4 lives every 6 months. Thank you for watching the video. Please like and subscribe.